10th standard sociology, unit 2, labor. Dear students, you have already observed the video of social science textbook questions with the answers. If you want to see them again, click on the I button here. This video consists of important extra questions other than textbook questions. Let's begin. First question, answer the following questions. First one, explain Karl Marx's view of the division of labor. Answer is, Karl Marx says division of labor creates less skilled workers. He classifies division of labor into two different divisions of economic labor and social labor. He opines that the division of economic labor goes with the technical and people's cooperation. The division of social labor achieves social control through class, status, and stratification. These are all about Karl Marx's view of the division of labor. Second question. The division of labor leads to specialization. How? Answer is, a different division of labor can be seen in a post-industrialized society than industrialized society. In the present digital world, the division of labor is done through computers. For example, in the information technological society, the division is based on various skills in using the computers. As we consult different doctors for different ailments, the computer technicians are consulted for various aspects of information technology related issues. In this way, the division of labor leads to specialization. Question number 3, explain the nature of labor without pay. Answer is, if work is done without payment, either in cash or kind, then it is called as labor without pay. Such works are called labor without compensation. Often, labor becomes an activity without any monetary benefit or material benefit. In payless work, the worker cannot be compensated for his work. This work often happens within the family due to love, by status, out of self-motivation, or by force. Examples: scouts and guides, NCC, ITI, and nursing courses. Another example can be that of an artist who engages himself in painting for his own satisfaction. These are all the nature of labor without pay. Let's move to question number 4. The women are being restricted to family and family related works only. How? Answer is, family based work comes under work without pay category. In a family setup, the burden of work is more on the women. Since women are bound by work at home, they are discouraged from finding work outside for compensation. This has made women the unpaid workers in the family. Though the women participate in the various activities of the family, her contribution goes unrecognized. And nowadays, it is being said that the work of women in the family is declared as more important. In this way, the women are being restricted to family and family-related works. Let's move to question number 5. Explain the nature of labor with pay. Answer is, the labor which gets compensation based on hours, days or months for semi-skilled or skilled work is considered as labor with pay. Labor in small business and roadside business, work in factories, work in schools as assistant teachers, construction work, vehicle repair, garages, agricultural farm works can be grouped under labor with pay. Though the compensation is meager, it becomes inevitable for the people to work in this complex social scenario. Compensation is an agreement between the worker and the owner. Sometimes, the compensation can be in the form of materials. These are all the nature of labor with pay. Let's move to question number 6. List out the challenges faced by unorganized sector workers. The challenges faced by unorganized sector workers are migration, social security, legal framework, child labor, and physical and mental exploitation. These are all the challenges faced by unorganized sector workers. Let's move to question number 7. Explain the challenges faced on migration issue by the unorganized sectors. Answer is, migration is one of the main features of unorganized sector. Laborers of unorganized sector migrate from one place to another place in search of work. The people who migrate like this have no social security. These are all about the challenges faced on migration issue by the unorganized sector. Question number 8. Explain the challenges faced on legal framework issue by the unorganized sectors. Answer is, for workers working in unorganized sector, many legal provisions does not apply at all. For example, these workers do not receive wages as per their work duration. The wages as per the Minimum Wages Act of 1971 are not available for these workers. Apart from this, they are also not eligible for Provident Fund and other such benefits. These are all about the challenges faced on legal framework issue by the unorganized sectors. Question number 9. The unorganized sector work promotes child labor. How? Answer is, children work in unhealthy environment in many semi-skilled and unskilled jobs. For example, children work in large numbers in firecrackers production. They work in dangerous environment and without any guarantee for life. The employer expects more work for less pay. Children become victims of this greed. In this way, the unorganized sector promotes child labor. Question number 10. Write a note on the book Footloosers. Answer is, in the book Footloosers, a study of circular migration is done. It studies the labor of people working in unorganized sector. It studies the inevitability of the people to migrate from their place living to place working is studied in this.